Robinhood Financial, LLC, member FINRA, /SIPC.
This is Nick.
This is Jack.
And this is Robinhood Snacks. We've got digestible financial news for you.
We got two stories. Nick, what's the first?
All right, WWE Network just tapped out, Jack.
And Clubhouse just became the first unicorn you can only hear.
Let's hear it for our first story. The WWE Wrestling Streaming Network, it's no more.
I used to wrestle on the trampoline in the backyard. Now the WWE Network lives on Peacock, NBC's newest streaming platform.
So you're gonna get like on-demand shows about wrestlers, 24-hour wrestling, and here's the key, live events like WrestleMania.
WrestleMania included in Peacock. Not a bad deal, starting now.
All right, so WWE Network just shut down, but they tried to pretend it wasn't a failure. They tried to pretend it was a victory. We kind of disagree.
Okay, keeping tabs here. WWE was charging $10 a month for WWE Network to over a million people.
Jack, I see your tabs. Now they're part of a network that's costing half as much with the same content.
Probably not a good thing when you're forced to cut your price in half.
So Jack, what's the takeaway for our buddies over at the WWE?
Tiny streaming companies call for tiny streaming prices.
WWE's network is the second small streamer to fail.
Quibi couldn't survive as a standalone service for $5 a month.
WWE couldn't survive for 10 bucks a month, and like Quibi, it was pretty small.
Both micro streamers. Maybe they could have survived if they charged a micro streaming price, like say $1 to $5 a month.
Jack, if your content's like a fraction of what Netflix has, you should probably charge a fraction of the price. For our second story, Clubhouse, the new social media app, you probably haven't been invited to it yet.
It's actually an audio-only social media app. It's by invitation only, and there's only 2 million people on it so far.
So here's how it goes down, Snackers. You enter one of these rooms on Clubhouse, it's gonna be like you, 8 other people, someone's unemployed, one person is Oprah.
Oh, hey there, San Francisco's Attorney General just popped in to say hello.
Well, that whole situation, Clubhouse just raised money worth $1 billion.
It's a unicorn.
One problem, Clubhouse doesn't make money.
Yeah, that's why they're learning to monetize now, because you kinda need to make money. We think they could make money by charging for audio masterclass.
So much of Clubhouse is educational, why not let the people who are speaking charge for the people who are listening?
Imagine, Tiffany Haddish hosts a room, charges $1 to get in because she's gonna teach you how to be funny.
Tiffany, we'll pay you to teach us funny.
So Jack, what's the takeaway for our buddies over at Clubhouse? Instagram, Snapchat, TikTok, they're all chasing the same social media creators. Clubhouse is
Instagram stole Kylie Jenner away from Snapchat. Who took her away from TikTok?
Clubhouse is audio only. Kylie doesn't even care about it.
An audio only social network needs audio only creators.
They should have done a masterclass on how to do a streaming network for WWE Network.
Jack, I love what you're thinking. ClassPass gets money, WWE survives.
Follow us at Robinhood Snacks on Instagram.
Or subscribe at YouTube at youtube.com/Robinhood app.
See you Wednesday.
Jack, we'll see you there.
This is Jack. I own stock of Netflix.